Hi, brain MRI is one of the most important tools to diagnose epilepsy and seizures, and almost every patient with epilepsy gets a brain MRI. We should know that not all MRIs are the same, and there are specific considerations for MRIs in epilepsy that makes it much higher chances of detecting any abnormalities and will lead to better care for you. For all the information, I'll be using one of the most important books for epilepsy, which is called Epilepsy Treatment by the Mayo Clinic Professors, which I got the chance to author one chapter in this book. And in that chapter, I detailed the MRI used in epilepsy. MRI is a brain scan that takes high quality and high resolution pictures of the brain using magnetic resonance. So it will be a powerful magnet that will take pictures of the brain, so there is no radiation in MRI. And the study itself lasts about 30 to 45 minutes, depending on how many sequences we do for the study. MRI itself is like a tube, and some people with claustrophobia can have, being tight places could not tolerate the MRI. And for this situation, we give a medication to calm you down and get you to sleep, such as diazepam or some tranquilizers. And some cases with intellectual disability or people who are like children, we can do general anesthesia to put them completely to sleep so that we can get them MRI successfully. And we have now open MRIs that are special types of MRIs that can relieve this anxiety and claustrophobia. MRI uses magnets, and the stronger the magnet, the better the pictures and the more high quality they can be. The older MRIs are 1.5 Tesla, and these usually can get pictures, but they are kind of grainy. And now we have much better MRIs of 3 Tesla that we prefer to do in every patient with epilepsy. And recently we have MRI that is 7 Tesla, which is a very powerful magnet that is approved for human use, and it is available in some centers of epilepsy, and they can be reserved for very complex cases of seizures. MRI is positive in epilepsy in about 30% of the time only, because the changes in the brain can be microscopic and very small, and we cannot see them grossly on the brain. But if we cut the brain, like in a surgery, or we look at the brain under the microscope, we can see those connections between the cells are disturbed, and that can be the cause of seizures. To get a better results of your MRI, we do a special epilepsy protocol MRI that can increase the chances of capturing anything abnormal to even like 50%, especially if it was read by an experienced neuroradiologist who have a trained eyes for the brain MRI. We have a recommended epilepsy protocol MRI that have extra sequences for detection of the brain abnormalities with thin cuts through the temporal lobes and some orientations. And those are the sequences that we recommend in cases of a brain MRI for epilepsy. IV contrast in general is not recommended routinely for brain MRIs for epilepsy. We only use contrast if we are suspecting neoplasm or a brain tumor, or we are suspecting inflammation in the brain, and the contrast makes it appear easier. And now we have new advancements in the MRI technology, and we have some computer softwares that uses artificial intelligence to look at the brain MRIs and analyze them in details, and gives us what we call volumetric analysis, which means that it gives us the volumes and how big and small those areas of the brain, such as the important place in the brain is called hippocampus, and those are getting shrinking and smaller in epilepsy. And we can measure the thickness of the cortex, and sometimes you cannot see it by your eyes, but if you do computer analysis, we can see much better details, and we do those analysis advanced in people with epilepsy that are needing epilepsy surgery. Is MRI safe in pregnancy? MRI by itself is safe in pregnancy because there is no radiation involved, and we actually can image the fetus and the brain of the baby while doing some fetal studies, and some babies have on the ultrasound issues with their brain, so it is safe in pregnancy. However, we should not give contrast in pregnant women, because contrast by itself can get into the baby, and that can stay in the skin and not get cleared by the kidneys of the baby, and that can lead to skin necrosis and skin issues. So MRI is safe in pregnancy, but contrast should not be given in pregnancy. Is there a situation I cannot get a brain MRI? And what about the implanted seizure devices? Most of the patients can get their MRI done. However, if you have a metal in your body, especially that is not compatible with MRI, somebody was shot in the head, if there is any fragments or bullets or anything that is in the brain or the head that is not compatible with MRI, we cannot do an MRI. Most of the materials and any implanted device that was made usually after early 2000s is compatible with MRI. And now every single device that is implanted in the body should be MRI compatible. And we have lots of engineering techniques to make the material MRI compatible. The implantable seizure devices, such as the responsive nerve stimulation, deep brain stimulation, vagus nerve stimulation, all of those are safe in MRI now. We have some adjustment in the protocols and some strength of the magnets depending on the device, but all of them are compatible with MRI. We should always, before the MRI, shut those devices off and then reprogram it after the MRI is done. Is it possible to have epilepsy with normal MRI and normal EEG? Well, the answer is yes. And I explained here in this video all the details on what to do if your testing comes back negative and you're still suspecting epilepsy. And stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.